A little bit different experience this time around. I mean, you were in a very difficult position, short notice, a ton of weight to lose the first time around. I wonder, you know, how much different is the experience this week, and did you take anything from that first experience?
The experience really this week, I mean, I've been here since Sunday, was able to get over the time difference straight away. It was literally before we left in the plane, I was in the gym. The minute we got here, I was in the gym. So despite the traveling and the time difference, I was able to get straight back in the routine of things. Come Monday, I was straight on Dallas time. So again, time difference made no difference, and I've been ticking over nicely since then. So that combined with my fight camp and my preparations, having the notice like 6 weeks compared to 12, my weight's been very manageable. It's been maintained throughout. It was already a lot lower when I started. I wasn't at 98 kilos. I didn't have to lose 46 pounds. So I've just been feeling strong throughout. I'm still feeling as strong now as I did at the start of camp, given the fact that I'm a lot lighter. I'm a lot more fatigued body-wise, just from all the training I've been doing, trying to fit around my schedule, like here and back home. Just it's really helped a lot, just having the notice and being able to have a sensible amount of weight to lose, and taking away that from the Neil Magny fight, just how it made me feel and the benefits from having the extra time for hydration, getting my refueling right. I just know that when that part comes on Friday, that I'm going to be a very effective fighter, a very efficient fighter. It's going to be a completely different version of me that people saw against Magny. With all the training we're doing, it'll be the best version of me, and I'm really looking forward to putting that on display for everyone.
I wanted to ask you that. I mean, you were in a tough spot regardless. I mean, even if you'd come in on full camp, you know, I mean, Neil Magny, you know, is a veteran. So for a lot of people, that fight's the first time they've seen you fight, right? I mean, what representation of that was you? I mean, is there a percentage grade, or was it even you at all?
It's hard to say. I mean, we took the fight, and straight away it was wake up. There was no fight prep. Like, obviously, I've seen Magny fight, you know, roughly what to expect. But I was going in there on basic instinct and just my ability to fight rather than my ability to be sharp for a certain fight for a certain fighter. And I hadn't been training as much as I should have done when I got the call. I've been enjoying a bit of time off from my fight with Cage, where he's in March. So I had birthday parties, weddings, just life getting in the way. And yeah, I just wasn't necessarily as best prepared as I could be, but by the time I went in there, it was as best prepared as I was going to be. I think with even 2 weeks more notice, so say I'd got the call and the offer when Nelson originally pulled out, it would have been a completely different fight. I would have had a lot more energy, would have had more of a camp and more specific training for Neil. And yeah, I think I could have gone in more myself than I did. And I think probably say about 50% of that was me as a fighter. I went in, I tried to adapt my game plan from the previous fight where I was fighting a guy who was about 6'4", he had a long reach. Magny's 6'3", had a long reach as well. Similar build, so I thought that would work, and it was working to a set point. Then I got kneed in the stomach, went downhill a bit from there, then got kneed in the stomach a second time and body didn't want to know, and then I got kneed in the head, which woke me up. But the only reason I fell to the floor is because Neil would stop supporting me against the cage. So I'm now on the floor, the ref telling me to move, like, oh, I'm fine, I'm fine. I'm like, I can't move my arms. I'm literally trying to not do T-Rex arms and stuff, and yeah, it was difficult, but when you get caught in a body shot, you can't recover from that, and my body was in no fit state for that regardless. So yeah.
How did this fight come together? You know, you go from that to fighting, I mean, a legend, a guy that's been doing it forever, you know, Diego Sanchez. How does this come together?
Just got asked if I wanted to fight on September the 8th, so got offered it, and then text my coach was like, oh yeah, we've been off to fight, what do you think? It's like, oh yeah, we've got enough time. It's a lot sooner than I expected to be in. I was thinking that Moscow might be a good shout, if not the Brazil show the week after. I thought that'd be the LSB, and if not, longer time went on, was thinking that'd be October, because I wanted a good 6 to 8 weeks notice. So for that, I was like, right, it's just under 6 weeks, so it'll be all right. And then I went, oh, who's the opponent? And then all I got sent back is this WhatsApp screenshot of, yeah, Craig White want to fight Diego Sanchez, and I was like, fuck yeah. call my coach up straight away before I respond to that. I'm like, oh, it's Diego Sanchez. And we're like, fuck yeah. And it's the type of fighter you want to fight. I mean, he's a legend of the sport and he's an exciting fighter, and I think our styles match up really well. So the actual true Craig White style, where I can come in and I'm happy to throw down, I'm happy to have this technical fight if I need to, I just want to come and fight and put on these entertaining fights for people. People are going to get to see that this time, and through me having the fight camp, that'll help. But having an opponent like Sanchez who wants to do the same, he wants to come forward, he's as crazy as they come, he's aggressive, and I'm hoping I get that Sanchez. I want the Sanchez that wants to rip my head off, wants to bring it to me so we can put on that fight. Because it's what the fans deserve, especially from someone like him and someone like me who's up and coming. I want people to see exactly what I'm about, what I'm capable of. And last time they didn't get the opportunity.
Is there a chance, I mean, obviously you're going to be on edge, you're about to get in a cage fight, but is there a chance that you'll be a little starstruck at all? I mean, he was fighting the UFC before you were even fighting, right?
Yeah, I mean, he was one of the reasons I probably started getting into UFC. I mean, that whole Ultimate Fighter 1 program was just the defining point in the UFC. Obviously, the fights got put on there and the people that have fought on there and since, they've helped shape the sport. So, to be fair, I can't remember back that far. I'm getting old and too many blows to the head, but just that whole like fight season was very pivotal in like my career, wanting to go from taekwondo to doing full contact martial arts, as well as just getting older wanting to do that. But I won't get starstruck. At the end of the day, I'm in there to fight whoever I'm in there to fight. Doesn't matter if it's Diego Sanchez, Neil Magny, whoever it is, I'm in there to do the job, but I'm going to go in there, get it done, and then afterwards I can maybe be a little starstruck if I get the chance to. If not, well, it don't really matter. I'm here to just turn up, perform, fight, do my best, and put on the show.
Have you tried to evaluate like what, you know, Diego Sanchez you're gonna get? I mean, you said you want the one that's coming after you. Yeah. I think we're all trying to figure out, right? I mean, the guy's been around for so long. Does he still have it? Is he a step slower? I mean, have you tried to calculate that at all?
I think it's a hard one to calculate. He hasn't fought in a year. He's coming off two knockouts. Anyone guess is as good as mine, but from what I've seen, what he's been saying, he seems to be very motivated. He seems to completely readjust his life, his structure of his training, seems to be working for him. He looks in great shape. He seems to be very adamant that he's going to prove a point of you don't need to cut weight to fight the weight class, which be interesting how that works out when you've got someone that's one of the heaviest welterweights in the division, one of the biggest, tallest welterweights in the division against him. But the great thing about the sport is anything can happen. So, as long as I get the best Diego Sanchez I can on the night, whether it's a Diego Sanchez of 13 years ago or from that 13 years, or the best Diego Sanchez of today, because that's all that's relevant, that's all he's going to bring, that's all I want. I don't want a Diego Sanchez which isn't quite all there, where people are just going to use that as an excuse. I want the best version of him so I can be like, well, yeah, I beat the best Diego Sanchez. There's no question about it. There's no excuses as to why I won. I won because I was the better fighter on the night.
Yeah, no doubt. When you look at this fight, how do you see it? I mean, are you feeling like almost, not that you get a free pass for the first time around, but I mean, does this almost feel like, okay, that happens, let's put it behind us, this is our debut, we got a full camp, you know, is that what this feels like to you, or do you feel like, hey, I'm tagged with that loss no matter what?
Once you've got a loss in your record, you can't get it off. There's no doubt about that. I mean, to say I would love to have a rematch with Magny with a full camp would be telling the truth. Like, I'd love to get the opportunity, and if I have to work my way up to that, then I will. Whether that comes to fruition or not, well, wait and see. If not, it doesn't matter, because there's a very deep division of welterweights for me to compete against, and they're all very talented and they're all great fighters, so future ahead is exciting. But in terms of seeing this, whether it's my true debut or not really. I mean, I've been doing this game a long time now. I've had a lot of fights, not as many as Sanchez granted, but every fight is kind of on an ad hoc basis. You take it as it comes. So yeah, I lost the last one. It happened as it did. I can't change that. Would I change doing it? No. Like, I got to have my opportunity in the UFC. I had a great platforming co-main event on your debut against someone of that caliber of an opponent. You can't turn that down. And in my second fight, I get someone like Diego Sanchez. It's every fighter's dream, but at the same time, a lot of people wouldn't have taken the fights. So I'm just here enjoying my journey, enjoying the adventure, and as long as it wants to take me, as far as it wants to take me, I'm here for that.
Best case scenario on Saturday night, you go in there and dispatch of him in 30 seconds to get a performance of the night bonus, or you go three rounds back and forth, you know, one of those epic Diego Sanchez brawls, and you get, you know, a fight of the night bonus.
Yeah, I mean, ideally I don't really want to go three rounds. I want to keep my finish rate intact. But if it has to go that far, I'm more than ready. My training's been adapted to that. We've been working way beyond the requirement for that. Could probably do five fights if I needed to, especially with the way I'm feeling. I mean, I feel great. So I just want to go in there, put on the performance, get the win, just cement myself in the UFC more than I already have, and just, like I said, show people what I'm about and just boost my profile.